Have you ever stopped to think about the real reasons behind the things you buy? I mean, we all feel like we're in control, right? But what if I told you that behind every single choice, from your morning coffee to your phone, there are these powerful economic forces at play? Well, today, we're going to pull back the curtain on two of the biggest ones that are secretly guiding your wallet. Think about it like this: coffee or tea? That's one kind of decision. But a printer and its ink? That's a totally different ballgame, a completely different relationship. Understanding the difference between these two examples is the key. It unlocks a huge piece of how our whole economy, and yeah, your own bank account, actually works. So let's start with the big picture, our economic choices. Every time you buy something, you're navigating this, well, this incredibly complex web of factors. And honestly, most of the time, we don't even consciously think about them. Look, it's not just about what you happen to want in that moment. Your decisions are constantly being shaped by your income, right? And the price of the item, obviously. But there are two other massive forces we're about to dive into, what we call substitute goods and complementary goods.
Okay, first up, substitutes. This is what I like to call the classic instead of choice. It's a decision we are all making constantly, pretty much every day, often without even giving it a second thought.
So what is a substitute good? Well, it's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It's any product you can use in place of another one to get the same job done, to satisfy the same need. You need a caffeine boost in the morning? You could have coffee, or you could have tea. They are substitutes for each other. Simple as that.
Now, this is where it gets really interesting. These products, they're locked in this constant economic dance with each other. Let's say you always buy Elite Coffee. It's your go-to. But one day, you walk into the store and boom, the price has jumped up. What do you do? Well, you'd probably glance right over at the taster's choice next to it and think, you know what, that's a much better deal today. And just like that, a price hike for one product creates a direct boost in demand for its substitute.
All right, now let's completely flip that idea on its head. If substitutes are the instead of choice, then complements are their polar opposite. They are the together with choice. These are the dynamic duos of the product world. You know, like peanut butter and jelly. One just doesn't feel right without the other. The key thing to remember here is that their fates are linked. You use them together, so a price change in one has this huge, direct impact on your desire for the other one. And this relationship is absolutely everywhere you look. If you drink coffee, chances are you also buy sugar. If you own a car, you have no choice but to buy tires. And that electric kettle on your counter? Kind of useless without water, right? The demand for these products is fundamentally tied together.
Now, this isn't just some fun little economic theory you learn about in a textbook. Oh, no. Understanding the incredible power of complementary goods has unlocked one of the most clever and, let's be honest, sometimes frustrating business strategies that's out there.
I mean, seriously? Have you ever actually wondered about this? You see a brand new high-tech printer on sale for a ridiculously low price, and you think you've just found the deal of the century. But the real cost and the real genius of the whole business model, well, that part is hidden.
So here's the trap. It's a model people call razor and blades. Step one is the bait. They sell you a super cheap printer, sometimes even losing money on it. Step two is the lock-in. That shiny new printer will only work with their specific proprietary ink cartridges. And step three, that's the profit. They charge an absolute fortune for that ink because they know you have no other choice. You have to buy the complementary good to make your first purchase work at all.
How much of a fortune are we talking about? Well, get this. The source material points out that a single set of ink cartridges can cost up to 500 or even 600 Israeli shekels. That can be way more than the price of the printer itself. They're practically giving away the printer just so they can sell you incredibly overpriced ink for years and years.
And it really all boils down to this one simple fact. Your dependency is the entire point. The printer was never the product they were actually trying to sell you. It's just the delivery system for the real moneymaker, the ink.
And once you see this strategy, I promise, you can't unsee it. It is everywhere. That free coffee pod machine, they make all their money on the expense of capsules. You bought a new iPhone? Great. Now get ready to pay a pretty penny for that proprietary charger. This even applies to bigger things. Owning a car in a city like Tel Aviv isn't just about the car and gas. The insane price and scarcity of parking is a massive complementary cost you just have to eat.
So let's bring it all together. What have we learned here? Well, it's pretty clear that our demand for stuff isn't random. Not at all. It's actually a predictable result of a few key economic forces that are always at play. Okay, so let's recap the four main drivers. First, you've got the price of the product itself, of course.
Then, there's your personal income level. And now you know the other two secret ingredients: the price of those instead of products, the substitutes, and the price of the together with products, the complements.
The real takeaway here isn't just a couple of fancy terms. It's a whole new perspective. You're now equipped to see the invisible economic logic behind everything on the store shelves. You can spot the substitutes, you can identify the complementary traps, and hopefully, you can make smarter decisions with your money.
And that brings us to a final thought, a question just for you. Take a look at your own recent purchases. Now that you know the difference, can you see where you're being influenced? Is it more by substitutes, that instead of choice? Or is it by the hidden costs of complements, the together with choice? What's really managing your wallet?